Let's lift our hands first and put our both hands. Let's reverence Him. Let's worship Him. He's the King of Kings, the Lord. Righteous Father, we say thank you. Holy Father, we say thank you. We bless the beauty of your holiness. It is because of you we are not consumed. The hour of light in the day, the hour of fly at night, the pestilence of darkness, you have not suffered us to have encounter with them because you have terminated them. This is the moment of truth. The time we've been waiting for. Father, send down your word that will make a difference in our life and in the name of Jesus. Is there anyone that is blind here? Let that person see in this light. Let the light walk. Those who give you a change of status, let them be a permanent in this sense of the mighty name of Jesus. You will let this one as a mark of fruitfulness. Let everyone listen to my voice. Let them be fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus. Cause your fruitfulness to multiply in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, above all, we pray for the spirit of wisdom. We pray for the revelation of knowledge. Let our eyes of understanding be enlightened as a word from God in this sense. Put wisdom in our minds. Put understanding in our hearts. All this we ask in Jesus' precious name. We have prayed. Yeah. Let's give Jesus a round of applause and shout of hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say to your neighbor, your left, your right, and welcome to the Living God Covenant Church. This is true church international. God wrote a letter to Timothy. God, the Apostle Paul wrote a letter to Timothy. He said, if I can, you ought to know how you will behave yourself in the house of God, the pillar and the ground of truth. The house of God, the pillar and the ground of truth. We're in the house of God, the living God. And this morning, God will be dispensing His truth to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Are you ready for it? Amen. Wonderful. Now, quickly, let's open our Bible to Genesis. Where are we? Genesis was particularly selected because it's the beginning of all beginnings. Be fruitful and multiply. With Jesus the Torah. That is your portion and portion of the mighty name of Jesus. Today's sermon is Psalm 695. And the topic is understanding fruitfulness with Jesus the Lord. We are looking at part one. Today is the first sermon for the series of understanding fruitfulness. Today's sermon is subtitled Covenant Day of Fruitfulness. Say, I'm having Covenant Day of Fruitfulness. Wonderful. Now, I must tell you, the love of God, that the original plan of God, the original plan and purpose of God for mankind is for mankind to be fruitful. It's for mankind to be productive. For man to have dominion, that is the plan of God. And that plan has not changed. That plan of God has not changed. Though Satan came to thwart Adam, Satan affected Adam. He came to make the plan defective. But God renewed the plan. He renewed it with the same ideology. And that's why we see in Genesis 1, verse 28. After he gave my blessing, he said, be fruitful and multiply. And replenish the earth. And have some people and have dominion. But after Satan came to thwart this plan, God renewed the plan again with the same purpose. If you bless us now, John 15, verse 16. Let us not pray for us. You see, the renewed plan of God. Why is it that God has created you? Why is it? What are you doing in this world? What is it? Why are you the kingdom of God? Why are you covenanted with God? It's not pray for us. John 15, 16 and 17. Quickly. 16. Yes.
Ye have not chosen me.
Now Jesus said, ye have not chosen me.
But I have chosen you.
But I have chosen you. Now, whatsoever you shall ask
of the Father,
in my name,
he may give it to you. 17.
Yeah.
These things I command you.
That
you love
that he loved one another.
If the world hates you,
ye know that he hated me before you. You can stop it. Thank you very much. Now, if you look at the first plan of God in Genesis and say, I came to thwart it by making Adam and Eve to sin. It is Satan and they sinned and they lost their dominion. And he took over their dominion. It started growing there. Then God came to restore that plan, that fruitfulness and multiplication. And that is why he's telling us in John 15, 16, he said, ye are not chosen, I have chosen you, that ye shall go forth and bear fruit, and that your fruit will remain. That every one of us, our fruit will remain. So he created us to be fruitful and for us to multiply. In the body of Christ today, we see so many people are not fruitful. And multiplication is becoming difficult. Why is it so? Because darkness has clouded the earth. We are told in Isaiah 16, verse 2. He said, darkness will cover the earth and cross darkness in people. He said, but for you, arise and shine, for your light is come. Now, this is the first sermon for the series of fruitfulness. But the whole of this month, we shall be looking at fruitfulness. Fruitfulness. What is fruitfulness? If you go to the dictionary, Oxford Dictionary, it defines fruitfulness as productiveness. For somebody to be productive. As abundance. For you to have abundance. That is fruitfulness. Also, it says for you to be fertile. For you to be fertile. Or like they call it fecundity. Fecundity is you having the ability to reproduce. You have the ability to have option to reproduce. When they say somebody is fertile, that this person can produce. Because some people are not fertile. Some people cannot reproduce. You hear it says some people are bad. So that is the dictionary definition of fruitfulness. It says to be fruitful is to have abundance, is for you to be productive, is for you to be fertile. But what is the spiritual definition of fruitfulness? What is the spiritual definition? Fruitfulness is both spiritual and physical. Fruitfulness is both spiritual and physical. It is when God commands his blessing upon you. Fruitfulness is a gift from God. He's the one that makes people fruitful. He gives you the fruitful. And you got the fruitful. He does as a like. It's a blessing. It's a gift. God can make one fruitful and make another not fruitful. Fruitfulness is not by your power, it's not by your strength. No man can be fruitful by his power or by his strength. It is when God has commanded you, say, be fruitful, you'll be fruitful. So it is what God says. And aside from the spiritual realm, and that is also people are confused about fruitfulness. It manifests in the physical, but it is from the spirit. He said, this one has to be our spirit and their life. God commands us to be fruitful, and that doesn't become fruitful. Jesus called to the future. He said, I can't see the much happen from you. That fish can die at the road. So it is one. And that time Moses gathered the whole children of Israel in Deuteronomy 30, verse 19. He said, I call heaven this day to be a record between you and me. That God has placed before you life and death, blessing and cursing. He said, then I advise you to choose life. I advise you to choose life so that you and your descendants. They flourish, they enjoy, they become fruitful. So, fruitfulness is also a choice. You have a part of it. No one has commanded to bless you. But what if you refuse it? If you reject it, Job 36, verse 11 and 20. If you obey my voice, if you obey my commandment, they shall spend their days in what? Prosperity.
And pleasure
evermore. He said they didn't disobey. If they refuse to obey, I will take away my life from them, and they shall do what?
Perish.
They shall be destroyed. Every fruitfulness you see today starts from what? From being alive. If you are not alive, you cannot be talking of fruitfulness. Fruitfulness starts from being alive. You can be alive if you are not fruitful. You are alive, but you are not fruitful. You are moving around. What seed? You are not alive. When you are not alive, everything you are doing is dominating. It is rubbish. Because it's not counted in the kingdom. You are just wasting your life. Like somebody going to a place wasting his time. You are not standing. So life begins, fruitfulness begins as new birth. This, today we are looking at covenant day of fruitfulness. We are looking at understanding fruitfulness. Today is the first time, so we need to understand this fruitfulness. Let's go to our Bible. We celebrate Genesis for today because we are trying to explain this fruitfulness, where it is from, the origin of fruitfulness. The origin of fruitfulness. The first time fruitfulness was mentioned in the Bible. Let's go to our Bible. In Genesis 1, verse 1 to 31, you see what we have read. If you go to 11 and 12, fruit was mentioned for the first time. Fruit. Let us start with that right in 11 and 12 verse. Then another one should be right in 20. The first time fruit was mentioned in the Bible. Genesis 1, 11 and 12. It is one very for us. In Genesis. Yes.
It says, and God said, let the earth bring forth grass.
And God said, let the earth bring forth grass.
And the herb yielding seed.
And the herb yielding seed.
And the fruit tree yielding fruit.
Woohoo! And the fruit tree yielding fruit. This is the first time fruit was mentioned. After his time.
Whose seed is in
itself?
Upon the earth.
Upon the earth.
And it was so.
And it was so. That's what?
And the earth went forth grass.
And the earth went forth grass.
And the herb yielded seed.
And the herb yielded seed.
After his kind.
After his kind.
And the tree yielding fruit.
And the tree yielding fruit.
Whose seed was in itself?
Whose seed was in itself?
After his kind.
After his kind.
And God saw what?
And God saw that it was good. Thank you very much. Now you see at the beginning, and God said, God spoke the word. He spoke the word, God said, and it came to pass after what he had said. And let them be fruit, yielding fruit. Seed, help yielding seed. And as the seed, that is how it is. But if you may not understand it very well, let's go to 22. You'll now begin to see when he blessed it. 22. It's one of the 22 for us.
And God
bless
them.
And God
bless
them.
Saying,
be fruitful.
Be fruitful.
And
multiply.
And multiply.
Fill the waters.
Fill the waters.
In the sea.
In the sea.
And let fowl multiply in
and
the
earth. And let fowl multiply in the earth. Thank you very much. Now, you see, 11, 12, fruit was mentioned. 22, fruitful. He said, be fruitful. He blessed them. And said, they should be fruitful. And when you go to 28, he now created man. He started creating man in 26. He said, let's create man in our own image and in our own likeness. So the man should have dominion over everything he has created. And after he finished creating man, he did bless man. He blessed him. He said, be fruitful and multiply. Replenish them. So you have dominion. So man was created in the image of God. God is fruitful. God is productive. So man was created in the likeness of God. We are supposed to be created like God because we are created in the image of God. You see? Everything God created from Genesis to, if you look at Genesis 1, up to the end, that's 1. Everything he created, he said it was good. But when he finished creating man, he said it was very good. Because man was, he created man in his own form and his own likeness. So that man can be in charge of the earth. While God is in charge of heaven, we are not in charge of heaven. He wants somebody to be in charge of the earth. Himself is in heaven, then we will be ruling everything. He blessed us and told man, look, be in charge of everything that is living. Every living thing. Every living thing. That you should be in charge of. So man, life, dogs, slave, everything living. You should be in charge. So you are supposed to have dominion. You are their king. That's why life is the king of the jungle. You are the king of the earth. And that is what man has. I said that was an honor. Say why? Go give man that kind of power. For him, this man, I know the way. And he comes the subtle way and make man to sin. And man lost that dominion. That power, man lost it. That's the fruitfulness, man lost it. And Satan took over and made it to him. So Jesus Christ came to restore back that feeling, that power that we have came for the restoration. And that is why you see in Revelation 5, verse 10, he said, Christ has made us what? Kings and priests unto our God. And we shall do what? We shall reign on earth. That dominion. We have to take the dominion of the money in the church. So every son and daughter of God, they are created for dominion. They are supposed to be fruitful. They are supposed to multiply. They are supposed to increase. Because they have, God has commanded his blessing upon them. So why are people saying? You have some people that are married. People that cannot help you. People that cannot be fruitful. Now, when we talk of fruitfulness, fruitfulness is beyond having a child. When we say fruitful, it's not just to have pregnancy and give birth. That is not the fruitfulness. Of course, it is the fruit of the womb. But fruitfulness is more than that. Fruitfulness is talking of the creative power of God. The ability of you to create things. Let's look at Genesis. Go back to Genesis. Let's see the creative power of God. We are told in Genesis 1. In Genesis 1, then in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day. And the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. This was the creative power of God. The one God was productive. God was very productive, the one. In one day, he created all of these things. The whole world was in darkness. What about all that God did? Darkness everywhere. And the Spirit of God was moving. Darkness everywhere. And God saw that it was not good. Why is it so? And he said, from light. He said, let there be light. And there was light. Light came. And after creating the light, he started creating different things. And now said, light should be separated from this. Let the land come. Let the waters go to this side. And he started to create everything. Created night, created day, started to create things. He has that ability to create anything and by his word. The same way man has the power, we have the same ability to create anything. Do we say it and we see it?
Amen.
This man, they say the power of life and death is in the tongue. It is true. It is not lying. When you see it, all of us will be praying. We'll be praying that for farewell. You don't be praying for that to work with his memory. We'll be praying that maybe the farewell and the 3 days event. Let them be farewell. And while we are praying, my sister said, we are saying, let them be going, let them be going. He said, no, the rain will fall after we have finished our event. So rain can fall. We were praying, no, the weather should be fair. The weather, there should be no rain. He said, then she added, He said, no, rain before. After we have finished our event, when the ceremony is over, rain before. Rain has permitted before. If I show you the photograph, the video coverage, if you see the ceremony, if you see how the cloud, how many of you don't worry that it's a rainy place? That rain used to fall in that kind of place. If you see the pictures, the video, you see the cloud, all the rain, they will not fall. The rain will not fall. Because the water has gone. You know, this rain is going to fall. Is it going to fall? It will be filled. Is it falling? Then after this ceremony, the event has finished. And we've entered very cool and we're on our way going. We were driving. Look at the rain. As if rain is pushing us. Because his children, they have prayed that this thing has to be solved. The occasion has to go very well. Because the great man of God is being made to rest in the mind in the match. There is power in what we say. And that is what the doctor says in here. When you say this, the spirit, the angels of God, they carry it. And they will go. And they will execute. So that is how God, when God says the truth. What is faithful is for you to take the deliverance. Are you not believing? It's faithful to believe. Whatsoever he says. So if you look at the whole creation, God was faithful. Creative. He had that creative power. And that is what he used to do creation. First day, second day, third day, fourth day, sixth day. It was in the sixth day. After he has given it, what did I go create again? There's one thing that is left. I want to create somebody that will be in charge. Let me make myself. Now I have to make myself. He now created himself. The modern man out of the dust. Half a body man. The breath into man. And the spirit of God entered. And now became a living soul. Just like God. The subject, we have to bless them. They have to speak his word for man. It's for his word, and that is how man will continue. Be fruitful and not fruitful. Now, when you talk of fruitfulness, like I said, fruitfulness is the creative power, your ability to create things. It's not necessary for you to have a child and give birth and all of that. That is not, of course, that is fruitfulness, but it is beyond that. It is ability to create things, to reproduce. Ability for you to reproduce. You can create anything creatable and even recreate yourself. That is what fruitfulness is about. And that is what God has given every one of us in the mind of the Jesus. And in this world of fruitfulness, we shall take the look of it in the mind of the Jesus. God is ready to show you the secret of fruitfulness. Some people think to give birth to a child is just for a man and woman to meet. So when they meet, child will come. Go and ask people that have saved for 5 years.